September 21st, 2022, a major date in the progress of the West Valley Demonstration Project. That was the day we started main plant demolition, and our workforce, our awesome workforce, got us here. And I couldn't be happier. What's been accomplished here by this workforce, I put up against anyone. It's been going for 2 decades, really, preparing for this moment.
We got to start main plant demo, yes. I've been here for 33 years. We've been building to that for a long time, right? So as a demonstration project, we did a lot of things to get the high-level waste into glass out of the building. Now the big push was deactivation of the building and all the buildings surrounding it, and then get that big building down.
Originally, the main plant process building was the reprocessing facility at West Valley. So a commercial entity, Nuclear Fuel Services, used the building to take fuel from reactors that was used in the reactors and remove usable uranium and plutonium. Kind of like recycling the fuel to remove any uranium or plutonium that was left in the fuel that could be reused.
To start demolition in September, it's a culmination of decades of work. It took millions of work hours.
It's a big deal, you know. I think when you look across the board from all the different people that have worked here, who still work here over the last 25 years now, you know, it's a big step forward for us. It's a big deal for the community. The folks here have dedicated, some of them, their lives to making this happen. And we're excited about it.
It was exciting to finally see us reach that milestone, that pinnacle that we've all been planning and waiting for at least the last 5-6 years as far as the planning phase goes of the demolition of main plant. But it's the great hurrah, if you will.
We went through a very rigorous readiness assessment process that involved going through the various regulations, the permit requirements, to ensure that both the contractor and DOE oversight was ready to start the deconstruction of the building.
Also, the emergency preparedness. We had a series of emergency drills that we put everyone through to make sure everyone understood the new unique nature of demolition and the hazards that could and were likely to result during this period while we're doing demolition.
And ultimately, we followed that up from the DOE and did our readiness assessment to make sure that they were ready to start demolition.
The readiness assessment process really is the go, no-go for doing demolition in this case.
And then we began main plant demolition.
So on the 21st, I actually started a speech at our morning meeting, and I said, as you're looking back through history of this site, everything that's happened since Carter signed the act led to this day. Anybody that's ever worked here for the last 40 plus years has really put in an effort to get us to the day that that building could come down.
I call the demolition the glory part of the project because it's such a high visual of your accomplishment, but it's all that painstaking work that goes on inside the buildings that often gets overlooked, clearing us and deactivating and deconning and getting all these process cells ready to this point.
We like to use the phrase deconstruction, where it's a step-by-step deconstruction, taking the building apart one section at a time and bringing it down, packaging it up, and then moving on to the next step.
I think of dancing, for example. It's often said that Ginger Rogers did everything that Fred Astaire did, but did it backwards. You took it apart. You did it backwards. That is hard work, and you got us here after 2 decades.
Of all the demolitions on site, the main plant was the highest risk of facility from a radiological contamination perspective. So, and that was always our plan when the way we proposed the project was to work through the lower risk facilities up into the most high risk facility, which is where we're at right now.
We're reaching milestones that some years ago we really didn't know how we were going to get to. And we're getting there now. And it's a total team effort. I mean, you can't even imagine how many guys and gals have played into making this thing come together and work.
We've gotten through basically 9 cells out of about 74. And that's a really good start. You know, all of the surveys and all of the information coming back environmentally shows that we are doing absolutely everything we can do, and there's just nothing being emitted from this. It's just proving that we can do this safely.
I've spent so much time, decades, working at the plant.
that to see the start of demolition really come to fruition was quite an achievement. It's really going exactly as we planned. We had no surprises. The equipment's working the way we want it to. The dust suppression's working the way we want it to. We're not seeing any air emissions. Yeah, things are good.
Wow, we're at main plant demo. It's been a long time coming.
To the entire team at West Valley, we made it. We finally got here. It's taken us a long time, and you've done it.
From the operators to the rad techs and the safety techs, the maintenance guys to purchasing and human resources and everybody else, you made this happen.
It's just time to pause and just celebrate that. Just think about that, where we've gotten. You've done it safely, our number one priority. You've done it safely, you've done it compliantly, and you've done it efficiently.
This was not something that management did. This was not something that somebody in Washington, D.C. did. This was something that the people here at West Valley did. Individual engineers and workers that figured out the challenges on how we could deactivate the main plant and then demolish the main plant. It was all done here, an incredible workforce.
So many hours, so much time, so much effort, pushing a rock up that mountain. And we're here. Congratulations.